Hello everyone, welcome to BIMModeler.com. In this video tutorial, we'll be discussing how to create a section head family, and we'll be assigning that as section head family in the project. So it will be easy tutorial. This is for beginner who is not understanding the section head, how it works. So let's start that. If I go to the project and if I start a new family, and before that, let's select the sections and to understand how the sections will be created. So if you see that the section, there is a straight line. In the end, we have one head and the other end, we have another head. So every object in Revit, you know that there is an instance property and type properties. If you go to the type property, edit type, and you have the option for section tag. So usually in an edit property, you'll have callout tag, section tag. You have to go to the section tag and click this button. It will open another type property dialog box like this. So you have to create a family and you have to assign a section head family in this place. This type will be assigned directly to the section tag. And so this is how it works. So we have to make a family and the family will be assigned here. The family type categories will be assigned directly here because we are assigning two families here. So it comes as another separate tutorial options. So we have to go ahead and select OK. Let's start a new family, family, file, new family. So this is going to be a section head family. So we have to search for section head. So annotation, let's check for section head. We have the section head option in this place and I can take the template. The template is upgrading. Let me go ahead and go to the check category. If you see that section mark, so it says such section marks, that's it. So you can create your own section tail or section head, whatever you need. So once if you selected this, you'll be able to go ahead and see that how it is defined. You can see that the intersection of the horizontal and right reference plane defines the connection. So this reference plane is horizontal and the right reference plane, if I select it, and this is the right reference plane by seeing the name, and which is the section joining place. This is the place the section line will come in. So do not move the horizontal or and the reference plane, right reference plane. So we should not move this two lines. That's the condition. And delete this note before starting any sections. So let's start that. So you know that every section is having some references. So if you need any references, you will be able to add it. Before that, we'll create a geometry. Go to the create line. I'm going to create a geometry like this. So our sections will be like this. And I will not be having the arc at the top like this. So it will be the showing the direction with the sections like this. So if you need the filled region, so you can fill this also, going to the create and fill regions. Make sure that you have the filled regions in this place and use the pick line to pick this object. And finish this. We have a solid fill here, so we'll be able to create it like this. So every sections, you know that it'll have a reference something like one, and if you go to the project, you can see that. So by default in the sections, it'll have a reference like this. It's a sheet number at what viewport it is in. So if you have in the same sheet A1034, this sheet, if you have multiple sections, it'll be numbered as 1, 2, 3 like this. So we can go ahead and we can define our own parameters in this place as a label. So if you know the AutoCAD, it is set as attribute. So in Revit, it is label. So we can click in the center place and we can say that sheet number will be added here. And in this case, I have filled the arrow mark. I cannot add a sheet reference number. So I can add that reference number, detail numbers. I can add it in the before like this. So now it will come one dash, I'll add a dash in this place, A101. So I can click OK. So this is how it comes. I'll be able to select this and I can assign a text property here. I can go ahead and it's only 3 is there. I will be creating 1.5 millimeter. and selecting OK, I'll be assigning this text size 1.5 millimeter area. So this is how it comes, and if you see that it is center middle, so that it remains in the center position like this. So this is how our section head looks. I'll be able to save this family into my desktop, and I can say that section head underscore BIM modeler option 1. And select save. Now I'll be able to load this into the project, and the family is loaded. And if you're able to see it, you can scroll down and see under the family it is annotation symbol. So we'll be able to go to the section head BIM modeler will be available in this place. Let's select this section head and sections value and go to the edit type as we discussed earlier and go here. Now in the before time you may not be having that option, and if you have seen this section head BIM modeler is available here, I'll be able to assign it. Before that, let me duplicate and filled. I'll be renaming this underscore BIM modeler. Okay, I'll be changing this into a section head like this. And if you want, you can assign it in both directions, but in this case I'm keeping it as same. Now if you see that BIM modeler BM, it is assigned. So I can select OK directly so that the option will be affecting directly to the available section heads. If you need, you can duplicate and change. You go ahead and apply it. Now if you see that the symbol got applied like this, and if you need your own symbols, you will be able to assign them whenever you want to create a sections. Do let me know if you have any questions related to this, and do share it with your learning friends. We are creating a series of tutorials for learnings on Revit and BIM softwares. We do BIM modeling services also to various companies, and we create parametric families for manufacturers as well. Do let us know if you have any requirements. We will be able to help you out in your projects. Thank you so much. I'll see you on the next tutorial.